What's up, guys? Welcome to today's video. My name's Cody, and today we're going to be taking a look at some Inside the Mind gameplay. For those of you that are new to our YouTube channel, what I want to do real quick is give you a quick recap. This channel exists to bring you some strategy, and the whole goal is to make you better at Madden 16. So if you guys are into getting better at Madden 16, make sure to hit that subscribe button. But anyways, guys, we're in our Inside the Mind series, and it's really my favorite series to do. And the reason that I like doing it so much is because I think it's the most beneficial. What we're going to do here today is we're just going to be playing a head-to-head MUT game, and we're just going to go down and just show you how we play, some of the things that we like to do, and some of the reads we like to make. Now, if you guys find this useful, be sure to continue watching. If you don't think you'd find this useful, then I'll by no means just click off and go watch somebody else's YouTube channel. But yeah, I think we can learn a lot of things from watching somebody play, not just for the good things that they do, but more importantly, I think we can learn a lot from the bad things that we do. I know myself, I make a ton of mistakes in this game, not necessarily because my scheme is flawed, but because I'm human and I make mistakes. So that is a little bit of an introduction to what we like to do with this series. Real quick, for those of you that don't know, I'm running the Arizona Cardinals offensive playbook, and you can actually purchase this full scheme for $10. It's in the description. You can find that there. And then you can also purchase the same defense. I'm running the New England Patriots defensive playbook, and you can purchase that guide below as well. But those are the two schemes I'm running. If you don't want to purchase it, we have plenty of free content available on our channel, so you can definitely check that out. But yeah, guys, some of the things that I've been struggling with lately in Madden here, first drive is just kind of standard first drive, you know. We're going to run the snugs, and we're going to run that split close fullback inside. Those are the two things I really like to do in the first drive, just kind of get a feel for what they're doing. So I'm going to mainly just run one or two plays, and just make standard reads to kind of get a read on what he's doing. So I go with my favorite play, zone a post, and just run it, standard as is. Real quick, I wanted to talk a little bit about this. So, I'm finding that I'm having a ton of issues in Madden 16 with patience. In years past, the game played a little bit differently. You didn't have to have as much patience. And it really is actually taking, in my opinion, maybe not more skill to be better, but just as much skill to be better, if that's something that's accurate to say. And so, what I mean by that is that it's skill in a different way than I think we've ever had to play before. We have to be very conscious of some of the decisions that we make throughout the course of the game. Third and twos are some of the most critical downs on the field right now. So my personal issue so far this year has been I blitz way too much, and I don't take care of the football offensively. Those are my two issues. And what you're going to find is in almost every single loss that I have, it's normally a lose in the turnover differential, or I give up way too many big plays on the defensive side of the ball. I'm going to try to start working on, kind of shoring up those mistakes a little bit. Because you put a lot of work into practice mode and developing good pressure. You want to be able to just blitz all game. But unfortunately, what we're finding in Madden 16 is you simply cannot blitz all game and be effective. I have not seen a player this year blitz every single play and be effective. The most effective players that I see are playing good two-man under coverage with some user underneath it and really work in that game. So we're not going to necessarily go two-man under all game, because I don't believe that two-man under is the only thing that you should be doing this year. But what we are going to do is we're going to start to be a little bit wiser with how we use our play calling. So with that in mind, guys, let's get into this footage. So, and there we see a big turnover on the offensive side. There's not a whole lot you can really do about that except from, never throw the ball over the middle. But I don't find myself getting hit-sticked enough to warrant me saying, all right, I'm never going to throw it over the middle. Since I've actually been seeing a lot of strong close since the patch. And see, there's a big play. So already starting off terrible. Dang it. So a lot of things we could learn from that. Number one, I'm in the wrong complete defense. If you guys check the guide, you're going to notice that we have a specific defense designed for the first drive. And unfortunately, I just didn't get into it. I thought I knew better than my scheme. I got out of my comfort zone and tried to do something special. And as you see, I gave up a 94-yard touchdown. Offensively, I didn't, you know, tap square when I caught the ball. I didn't dive, so then I take it a hit stick over the middle, get a fumble, and that's Madden right there. I mean, that's how quickly things can turn around for you. So it's important not to get discouraged, but it's important to fail forward. Learn from your mistakes so that you don't make them twice in a row. So hopefully we'll be a little bit better on this drive. But a lot of things we can learn right there just from a matter of learning from my mistakes. All right, let's see what we do here. Ends up sending some good pressure up the middle. That's probably one of the better pressures I've actually experienced since the post-patch, and that was a 3-4 under, so he does have some pressure, so that's interesting. Let's see if we can't pick this up. There, we pick the pressure up, and we get the ball out of our hands. We're going to get a first down. Go ahead and square dive so we don't take any shots. I don't know how that went. That guy got a block shed. That's unfortunate. So some good heat here early on. He's rocking Vic Beasley. I don't really know much about that card. I haven't used it. So we're just going to have to see here. I don't know if this will pick the blitz up or not. And it doesn't. So luckily I got the ball out of my hands quick. I knew exactly where my receiver was going to be. So I'm finding in the post-patch edition of Madden that the big one that you want to be doing is you want to be sliding your line to the right. So we'll see if that helps any here. And I think we end up picking it up there. So the key for me is slide protecting my line to that side. So here, slide them to the right. No flat protection because he's setting his own pressure. There's a double juke from Reggie Bush. Stutter move, big play. So the key when facing good pressure, because this guy has this blitz is actually in our guide. I'm pretty sure. Well, not this specific blitz, but a blitz that kind of mimics the same type of pressure, and he'll run it most of the game. That's how most people play. This is why I would say the 3-4 under is not the best defense, because the fact that you can only send that heat. I haven't seen very many people go 3-4 under pressure from 2-man under, or 3-4 under pressure and really any pressure that's going to make me worry about it from the left side. So that's why I'm sliding my line to the right. Yeah, so that's what we're doing here. Looks like he's bringing a user play over there. Send some more pressure. Tony Romo makes a terrible throw. I did not mean to lob that. And I'm actually finding that another one of my mistakes, I said patience on the offensive side of the ball, but another one of my mistakes that I've actually been making a ton lately is the bad timing. Just bad timing. I had one game where I threw two interceptions simply because I just had bad timing. Really nothing else really outside of the timing. It was purely a timing issue. And there we get a touchdown. He tried to lurk me. And unfortunately that route just is not something you want to try to lurk, in my opinion. It's a very effective route. And the main reason for that is because it has a specific cut. It's very hard to user control. So yeah, pretty good drive from the offense to come back and make a big score there for us upon a turnover and then a big play given up by the defense. This guy's team is pretty good. I think he's at the DRC. So definitely going to have to watch out for some man coverage as the game progresses. He's going to start going to America's defense now. I guarantee that we'll see some two-man under from the quarter normal probably coming up on that next drive, because we kind of, you know, really did a pretty decent job of stopping some of his main pressure. So hopefully we can be ready for that. Defensively, we've just got to make sure that we're not giving up big plays. And that's really the bottom line. So we're going to come out and try to really hammer home some standard defense, nothing too crazy. So there's strong power. He gets another big run. A good run again. Haven't seen this. I have not seen strong power yet this year. Ran on me consistently. And there we are. There's the run defense that we like to use. Coming up big for us. Ends up running it. So an interesting call there on 3rd and 7 to run the ball, and he ends up scoring. So defensively right now, we are playing really terrible. The thing is that you're going to go with this inside the mind. A quick note here as we kind of, you know, look ahead to the next stage of the game. You know, the guide is good. We're going to give you pressure. We're going to give you good pressure. We're going to give you good plays. We're going to give you good passing plays. All that is good. What you're going to see here more is more of like us fighting through adversity, fighting through the adversity of someone breaking a 94-yard run on the first play from scrimmage from their offense. You know, someone calling a running play on 3rd and 7, very counter-cultural to what we're going to normally see online against, and really just against most players in general. And so, because of that variance, it's going to give you a lot of different looks at the guide. That's why I think that this is so important, is it's going to show the consistency of the guide of being an effective scheme. While we may get, you know, while we may get beat, you know, here or there, for the most part, what should occur is the scheme should stand up against most, if not all, D's. And there's the offense making a huge play. And it's very, very good against cover two, that play right there. If you run cover two against that play, it's a touchdown every time. But yeah, definitely a good play there. So defensively, we just have to stand up. We got to force him to pass. I mean, quite honestly, he's committed to running the football. So, and end up run committing there. We're going to get in for two. Defensively, like I said, right now it's really, really important that we at least hold him to three. I think he's going to go ahead and take the ball coming out of half. So defense has a big task here because we have not looked good in the opening quarters. So we'll see what we can do here against this guy. There's a quick pitch to the outside. Like I said, this run defense we've got is pretty good. I think it does a really good job of containing the run. That's why I like it so much. If we really want to stop it, we can go down to another set we have in the guide. But um, But when they're running these wide runs like this, I think this is a really good little play. A good double juke there to cut it back inside. Let's see what he does here. And he is making some good cuts. Runs a little corner strike route. I think we should have got that pick, personally. Runs a little power dive. Interesting little play scheme. I'm not seeing anything like this one. Strong power. He's running the ball well. And there we are. Here we're going to try to take advantage of a passing situation. He's going to run it. Great call by him. We end up getting a nice big-time block shed from Eric Reed over there on that outside, setting him up in a third and long. This is where we have to make a play. He goes ahead and runs it, checks it down. He's going to take his field goal, looks like. We'll take a TO here so that we can get at least a kick return. So, in the end, we shut him down. He seems pretty committed to running the football. So, we just have to be aware of that. I think he'll take the ball coming out, so... tough situation for us right now, but I mean, we're fine. We should be okay. I mean, big picture will be... we should be alright. So, not too upset. I'm kind of upset with the fact that... just kind of upset with the fact that we haven't really deterred him from running yet, and I guess that's part of like the scheme, because we're really trying to not really care about the run, because if they're running the ball, they can't be getting big plays, is kind of the mentality. But obviously he did get one big play on us, so there he gets a quick crossing pattern. There's the quick pitch. And he's running the ball. He's definitely running the ball on us. Little crossing pattern. We're going to make a little adjustment out of this. We're going to go into this big dime 146. See if we can't make some plays here. There's the pressure from the dime 146 looping in. The reason we're going to this is because we got to start kind of deterring his basic little plays here. I don't know how he's doing this. I don't know. His line must be, like, crazy good. So, tap, you know, tip your hat, and he's going to have to go for two here. He's actually going to only go for one. This is kind of a mistake on his part. Puts us still in range to go tie the game. That's why I go for two guys, for situations just like what you're seeing right here. Now, we're in a position where we can go down. It's only one possession game. I talked all about it. In my opinion, it's the game is more about possessions than it necessarily is about scoring. It's really, you know, largely a game of how many possessions you can stay with your opponent. Offensive strategy here, I mean, we just got to get down and score. You know, whatever it takes to score right here. He's seen a lot of the snugs, but I don't feel very threatened by his scheme right now, defensively. Except when they freaking teleport. Is that Pete? I don't know about that one. I don't know about that one right there. Definitely not for sure on that one. See what I said, that, and now you're starting to see it. This is that two-man under stuff that I was talking about, that he was going to go to, inevitably. So I'm trying to kind of figure out what I want to do to attack him. See if we can hit Bush. A little crossing pattern. And there's Bush making a big play. He gets tripped up, unfortunately. When they go to this man-up three-deep defense, though, real quick, we have a couple of plays designed to really take advantage of the coverage on the field. So, have to take off with Romo here, make a big-time move. Romo, I don't know, he does not have very good speed, but he makes a huge play for us. Hits Sanders. Big catch by him. Get other one on the curl. Good little play there. Hit Hopkins on the little slant pattern. What I'm seeing is a lot of man. I mean, it's been man the whole drive, right? So we're running mesh. We're running a mesh concept from the guide. Had a PA zone across. So pretty nice little play there. Archer right here. You have to at least give yourself a shot. I like my chances this year with the quarterback sneak. At least quick snapping at once for me is pretty solid on inches. Here we're going to fake playmaker him. Go ahead and get the inches. Now we got first and goal from the inches. And normally it's just a matter of quick hiking the quarterback sneak. As you see, we just really, you know, got up to the line quick and made that quick hike. And that was really the end of it. So, like I said, the key is just being able to hike it real, real quick like that, and hopefully he'll make a mistake. Looks like he's going to go full with the field goal block, so we're going to check back down into the pitch here. Nobody outside will be able to get out there with Archer's speed and get in for two and tie the ball game. Hopefully the defense can come up with something here on in this position. Defense has not played great today, but we have fought through the adversity, and we're still in a position to be able to play here. So well, Dive 146 had some success, so we're going to stay with that. We're going to find the right play here. Our strong power. I think we're just going to have to eat it. And come down in the box. There we are. So that's a big stop for the D. This situation, we're going to play some coverage defense from the Dime 146. I don't use the Dime 146 quite as much. Probably as even I should. Ends up getting a delay of game penalty, so that's a big penalty. 5 yards on third down is huge. Trying to see here in this situation who I want on the field. Playing some motion games there. Has to take a TO. This is a big down, guys. I mean, it's a big down right here. There's a corner route. We've got a guy right on it, and you can't get mad at that. Can't get mad at that one. Nothing really else to say on that one. He made a catch. Knew it was coming. Didn't go over there with the user because thought the man coverage could handle it. Obviously, it was not able to. So there's a defense stepping up for us. Third and 15, we give up a first down on a corner route. I would suspect he's going to run it. Going with the pass here. We've got good coverage. So we're back in the same situation again. Go strong power. Gets a block. He's going to go ahead and go in for 7. That's fine. I'm okay with giving up the touchdown here because we can go down and score. I've never seen someone run the pistol ace, honestly, this season. I mean, this is something from Madden 15 that a lot of people ran, Madden 25 a lot of people ran, but haven't seen it much this year, and so it's really caught me off guard. We have not been able to stop it. We've had a couple of situations where we've been in the vicinity to make a play, and we just have maybe missed a tackle or we've gotten back juke or whatever, but and here Dre Archer's going to make a big-time return for us. But we got plenty of time on the clock to go down and win the game. And that was really the whole idea, was that we were going to play high-risk, high-reward in that situation because he would have been able to clock me out if I would have just went standard. So here it looks like he's going to send some pressure. So there Romo hits a nice dot to the outside. I think Romo's only thrown 3 incomplete passes all game. So, I mean, you can see the precision the offense allows you to have. The early turnover is certainly going to come back and has had definitely an impact on the game. There we get a late read to Bush. Trying to get out of bounds there, couldn't do it. So I'm not quite sure what he's running. I think it's just a variance of man. But there's Keenan Allen making a big catch. Almost dropped the frickin' ball again. This time he hangs on to it. So now this is where we can kind of get down and get down into our pro set with the timing. With the time that's left on the clock, we can really make a push here to really manage the clock here. So we're going to see a lot of quick heights, no huddles, things like that. Is what you're going to see right here. This is our pro set. We did not mean to call that play. I called a running play, and unfortunately the controller for some reason clicked the play action play instead of the running play. So I'm kind of sniffing out potential here for cover 2. So we're going to see what he does. Romo barely gets the ball away. So we're in a sketchy little positioning here. We're going to go to a play we don't normally run. Well, we don't normally run. We run it a lot, actually, but we haven't ran it yet today. And we're going to see what we can do here on 3rd and 17. If he goes man coverage here, it's definitely a good call. He does go to man. Unfortunately, he did not block, he did not stop Reggie Bush. And Reggie Bush is going to get down in position here. This is the ball game. And we get caught on our defensive lineman in a big loss. Should not have ran no huddle right there. Should have gathered myself. That's a big mistake. That's going to be a game-changing mistake. So defensively, we played pathetic all game. We didn't stop the run. I mean, quite frankly, we didn't stop the run. That's the bottom line. That's on defense. I mean, we didn't stop the run at all. I mean, we gave up 3 big runs. Probably the worst performance I've seen us have in a long time. We didn't run our run defense very much. I tried to kind of stay balanced. But, tough game. Tough game to lose. We'll go ahead and post this. I think we can learn a lot from my mistakes. Some late game mistakes I made there. You know, I made the mistake of not gathering myself. Tried to quick hike him. Didn't have a good play on to do it with, and ended up getting, you know, facing the consequences. Knew he was going to go cover two, and I just don't have a really good play for cover two in that situation. From that play that I had on, I have a better play in my playbook for that. So, you know, next time be sure to gather yourself. Defensively, we just did not play very well. Offensively, I think we were fine for the most part. As you can see here, we played really, really, really well. 80% completion, 367, no picks. Unfortunately, we had a fumble early on in the game, and we did not stop the run. That's the bottom line. Take care of the football and be patient defensively. So thanks for watching, guys. Make sure to check out those guides.